So in Mendeleev periodic table, what exactly I was given previously? The physical and chemical properties of the elements are the periodic function of their atomic masses, right? So the same story here by Lothar Mayer. Unfortunately, he won't get that much great name and towards his classification, but actually he also was given some kind of classification similar to Mendeleev actually. So what exactly he said, the physical and chemical properties of the elements are the periodic function of their atomic volumes. I repeat, the physical and chemical properties of the elements are the periodic function of their atomic volumes. Okay, as I shown here, he was given a graph between atomic volumes versus atomic mass. Okay, so very simple. What exactly the difference between Mendeleev periodic table and this Moseley's classification exactly, sorry, Mayer's classification exactly. He was considered atomic volumes, this Lothar Mayer. Mendeleev was considered atomic weights, unless both are same. Okay, so here you can observe the difference between what exactly Mendeleev and Lothar Mayer's periodic classification. In Mendeleev, I shown in previous, he was given elements in periods and groups, but he represented by using these curves. Okay, if you observe this graph, here you have atomic volume and here you have atomic mass, and you can observe here some elements was represented in these curves. Okay, these are the highest volumes occupied by alkali metals. You can see lithium, sodium, potassium, rubidium and cesium, which occupy the maximum peak of these graphs everywhere. And bottom, if you can see here, some transition elements you have. Here some aluminium, here you have a carbon, you have here. Okay, and one more thing, next to highest peak, which elements are present means very important question, that is alkaline earth metal. See here, lithium, after you have actually beryllium, okay, and here sodium, after you have magnesium, and here you have a potassium after calcium, and rubidium after strontium, cesium after barium you have. Okay, and lowest occupied by these transition metals actually. Okay, so transition metals having almost equal volumes, you can observe here. See, chromium, manganese, iron, cobalt, nickel here. Getting what I am saying? And here also ruthenium, rhodium, palladium here. I was not written, but you can understand here. So palladium you have there. And afterwards you have like transition element, triodes I was given. Three triodes was kept in 8th group, I told you, in Mendeleev periodic table. But the same story here, but unfortunately, he was not given in periods and groups. He just given some peaks, otherwise we can call them as graphs. Okay, so between atomic volumes and atomic mass, he was given simple graphs just for representation of elements where they occupy. In this way, he was classified like this, no problem actually. So lithium, and here you can see one more small difference here. You can see here you have a lithium and here you have beryllium. See, everywhere I told you that after alkali metals you are getting alkaline earth metals, but here this beryllium has less atomic volume than this lithium. This is one exceptional case you have to identify everyone. Okay, so here the only reason, the packing of this beryllium is very close. Suddenly, if they closely packed, volume will decrease. So that is only the reason this beryllium has more less atomic volume when comparatively the remaining. Okay, so these are the things here you can remember. Okay, so in Lothar Mayer's periodic law, what I told you, the physical and chemical properties of the elements are the periodic function of their atomic volumes. But here, as we discussed, there are so many demerits because there was no certainty in that particular, no stability in that particular classification. Okay, and one more thing is that there is some clumsy here. See, chromium, you have manganese, you have cobalt, you have nickel, you have. What are their properties? They belongs to whom? Okay, these all things was not explained very clearly. So later on, we had a very, very important classification, that is Moseley's periodic classification, Moseley's periodic law. What exactly that? We will see now. Okay, so you must have a screenshot and you must write notes. Okay, so that you have to do continuously. And now we will enter into that Moseley's periodic law. What exactly Moseley's periodic law? Let's see now. So as we seen in previous in Mendeleev periodic table, we had some drawbacks. Exactly, what are those drawbacks? Means few elements like alkali metals and koinase metals kept in same group, and alkaline earth metals and zinc, cadmium, mercury kept in the same group, and few elements are in decreasing order of their atomic masses. Hydrogen place was not certain. Okay, and why those triads kept in same group, and some elements have exactly same atomic masses. I was given in previous, argon atomic mass is 40, calcium is 40, but he said I was arranged the elements in the increasing order of their atomic masses, but it is exactly not true, because some elements are in decreasing order and some elements have same atomic masses. Certainly that was failed. Of course, there are some merits, as I told you, groups, periods, as well as some unknown elements, he given properties and he kept some gaps for those unknown elements. These all things are very nice actually, exactly about Mendeleev, but there are demerits. Though with those demerits, we cannot arrange more than 60 elements. Getting what I'm saying? So now we have around 120 elements. So to arrange those elements, there must be a some like a fingerprint property. That fingerprint property we call as the atomic number. Getting what I'm saying? Why I said that fingerprint? Fingerprint can never be same for two, right? In that way, atomic number can never be same for two elements. So he was considered atomic numbers. Who? Mr. Moseley. He said atomic numbers are the best way to arrange elements. So he said, Mr. Moseley, the physical and chemical properties of the elements are the periodic function of their atomic numbers, he said. Who said? Mr. Moseley. Getting what I'm saying? So I repeat, Mendeleev was used atomic masses, Lothar Mayer used atomic volumes, now this Moseley was used atomic numbers instead of those, because there are some demerits, we have to avoid those. Getting what I'm saying? So periodic classification also like a development from one to another, like a human development or society development, or else suppose best simple example I'll give you. We started with the small landline phone, correct? Afterwards we had a small phone, and then now we have a smartphone. See, the both are same exactly. Utilization is same, function is same, but the thing is development. In that way, you have in periodic classification also, you have a development from demerits to merits. Get it? So finally, what I am saying here, the physical and chemical properties of the elements are the periodic function of their atomic numbers actually. Okay, what is the meaning of this? The physical and chemical properties of the elements depends on atomic number. Simple way, in our language. Okay, so the physical and chemical properties of the elements depends on atomic numbers, not on atomic masses. Because few elements have almost same atomic masses and few elements have exactly same atomic masses. So atomic mass is not like a fingerprint. Atomic number is like a fingerprint. It will be individual for a particular element. So no two elements will have same atomic number. Okay, so he only given atomic numbers for few elements by sending radiation X-rays through elements with some frequency nu, and this nu and he was given relation root nu is equals to A into Z minus B. And he was observed that not like in previous curve, this curve is exactly root nu versus Z. He got a very much straight line with a positive slope like this. Means as frequency is increasing, the atomic number is increasing. That means no element has or no two elements have similar atomic number he observed. Okay, what exactly his observation? Individually, every element required some certain frequency. No two elements is required same frequency, he said. Getting what I'm saying? He sent X-rays through elements and he observed ejection of electrons. One electron ejected, that is hydrogen. Two electrons ejected, that is helium. Like that, those electrons is equal to atomic number. Getting what I'm saying? I told you also in previous about isotopes, like that I told you. There I told you atomic number means what, mass number means what. Atomic number is equals to number of electrons or number of protons. I was given very clearly in previous. Get it? So you have to keep in your mind all these things. Okay, he observed the number of electrons ejected when the radiation sent through elements. Getting what I'm saying? So different elements require different frequencies, and different frequencies giving different number of electrons. Okay, so based on the ejection of electrons, he identified that yes, atomic numbers are exactly unique for a particular element. Who are unique? Atomic numbers are the unique for particular elements. So what he did, he sent some frequencies through elements and he observed the ejection of electrons. Electrons are not visible. When electrons are ejecting, we have to keep some fluorescent screen. When those electrons hit the screen, they will glow brightly. Okay, in atomic structure we had that. Getting what I'm saying? So here, okay, one spark light you have, so one electron. Two spark lights you have, two electrons like that. So you will have like a flash. Three times you have a flash, three electrons ejected. Atomic number is three, like that he was given. Getting what I'm saying? So finally, these all things are useless for us. Seriously, I'm telling. But what he did, I have to explain. That's why I'm telling. Otherwise, just remove from in your mind exactly. So just keep one thing in your mind, that is Moseley's periodic law. What exactly that? The physical and chemical properties of the elements are the periodic function of their atomic numbers. But here also some problem you have. Do you know what is that problem? You can arrange the elements by using atomic numbers. But where we have to stop? Means suppose we are arranging elements in a particular period. We started from hydrogen and we have to stop after helium or not? That's the problem. Suppose we started second period, we started with lithium, and we have to end with what element? Getting? These are the simple some issues here, where in Moseley's periodic law. There is nothing wrong here, no mistake. But only thing is, Moseley was not given periodic table. He was given the physical and chemical properties of the elements are the periodic function of their atomic numbers, he said. Why he said? He was unable to arrange the elements in various groups and periods. Why he was unable to arrange the elements in various groups and periods? Because what is the starting and what is the ending? That he was unable to given. Who was unable to given those kind of arrangement? This Mosley. So correct arrangement was given by later scientist was called Bohr. Niels Bohr was given modern periodic law. Okay, Lothar Mayer after Mosley we have. Mosley after we have Bohr's periodic table. That's what exactly we are using right now. Not only right now, in future after 100 years also we will use, not we exactly, our generations will use that periodic table only. Getting what I'm saying? So that exactly the periodic table what we have, a modern periodic table, and that we have to discuss now. So forget about all these things. What is the root mu is equals to z into that a into z minus b. What are a and b? A and b are the constants there. So we have no need to worry about those. He was considered atomic numbers. Who is that fellow? Mr. Mosley. Okay. Now we have to discuss about modern periodic law, which was given by Bohr. What he said? The physical and chemical properties of the elements are the periodic function of their electronic configurations. Yes, he was considered electronic configurations to arrange elements. So I repeat now, the modern periodic law, the physical and chemical properties of the elements are the periodic function of their electronic configurations. Sir, why we have to use electronic configurations? I told you the number of electrons in a shell, number of electrons present in subshells. So if the electrons completely filled in a particular shell or subshell, you can stop that period and you can repeat the same filling of electrons in the next particular subshell. I was given the energy of subshells in previous, half Bohr principle I was given in previous, right? Half Bohr principle, that Mueller diagram I was given. According to that, in the increasing order of energies, we have to fill electrons. Okay, in that increasing order of filling electrons, we have to classify elements. Getting what I'm saying? So what exactly Bohr did means, he was arranged the elements in various groups and periods. Same, he was used same concept what was followed by Mendeleev. He was arranged elements in groups as well as periods. But every period he was started with certain element. Every period he stopped with certain element. Getting what I'm saying? And one more thing, every period he started with the alkali metals and every period he ends with the noble gases. Getting what I'm saying? And one more thing he said, the elements who are present in group, they will have similar properties, he said. Here group means only one vertical column, but in Mendeleev, one group consists of two vertical columns from 1A to 7A, I told you, except 0 group and 8th group. Every group consists of two vertical columns in Mendeleev, but whereas in modern periodic law, which was given by Bohr, each group consists of only one vertical column. In that way, there are 18 groups and 7 periods. So I was given very clearly. Each group consists of only, getting what I'm saying? Each group consists only one vertical column. Okay? And he was started every period with alkali metal and ends with what? Noble gases. Getting what I'm saying? Okay. And in that way, how many periods you have? 7 periods. And now, how he was arranged elements means, as I told you, he was considered electronic configurations. Then Hauser means, what he did, he was just added electrons in various subshells in the increasing order of their energies. Who was did like that? Mr. Bohr did like that. Okay, what he did, he just filled electrons in various subshells. Okay, he was filled electrons in various subshells. And in the increasing order of their, increasing order of their means what? Their means here subshells. In increasing order of their subshells, he was arranged elements. Okay, increasing order of what? Increasing order of energy. Sir, how we will get energy of subshells? By using Euler diagram. Okay, electron first fill in what subshell? 1s. 1s after filling, electron next enter into 2s. That we know in Euler diagram. I was given in our previous class. Okay, so he was filled electrons in various subshells by considering the energy of subshells. Electron filling takes place in the increasing order of their energy of subshells that I was given. So, one thing, to classify elements, he was considered single word, Aufbau principle. Getting what I'm saying? Bohr was filled or classified elements by filling up of electrons in various subshells by considering what? Their energies. Okay? In what way? Increasing order of their energy. He started filling electrons with 1s and ends with 1s, first period. 1s after which period will come? 1s after which subshell will come? 2s. 2s after which subshell will come? 2p. Do you remember that? So I'll write those also in the increasing order of various subshells, how he was filled those particular elements we can see now. Okay, let's see what is a Bohr's classification. First, before that, let's see what is that Aufbau principle. This I was given already, but again I am writing because we must understand that very clearly. 1s, 2s and 2p. Here you have a 3s, 3p and 3p. This is the first shell, second shell, third shell and fourth shell. 4s and 4p, 4d and 4f. Next, 5s, 5p, 5d and 5f and 5g here. In that way, 6s, 6p, 6d and so on like this. And here 7s, 7p, 7d like this. Okay, how we have to fill electrons? In this way, diagonally. First 1s we have to fill and then 2s and then 2p, 3s, 3p, 4s, 3d, 4p, 5s, 4d, 5p, 6s and 4f, 5d, 6p, 7s. This is the way of filling of electrons in various subshell. So this is very clear. Okay, so we have to fill electrons in various subshells by considering their energies. Okay, so filling up of electrons in various subshells takes place in the increasing order of their energies. Who said like that? Mr. Hauser. This diagram is what? Euler diagram. Okay, so now let's see how each period he was classified. This is very important for today's class because this periodic table nowadays we are using. without this periodic classification, you cannot understand group elements, period elements, and some coordination compound chapter we have. Okay, so next D and F block chapter we have. What is D block? What is F block? What is S block? So those are all things we must know. Okay, so first of all, we have to understand how he was classified each period, how he started a period, how he ended period. Let's see one by one. So just observe the Aufbau principle. First electron enters into what subshell? 1s. So every period starts with the s subshell. Starts with what subshell? S subshell. And ends with P subshell. This is the most important statement for today's class. Every period starts with S and ends with P subshell. How? Let's see. Okay. First he started first period like this. Why this is called first period? Because first electron enters into 1s. Here what is the number here? This one. 1 is the small n value I told up. Yes. So first period starts with 1s and ends with 1s only. Because in first shell there is no P. Then you said, no sir, every period ends with P except this first period. This first period starts with 1s, ends with 1s only. Because shell wise he filled. This is called K shell, I told you, right? K shell consists of only 1s. Just go through my previous class so that it will be very easy for you. K shell, L shell, M shell, N shell, like that I told you, na? So in K shell, how many subshells we have means only 1s. And in L shell, how many subshells we have means 2s and 2p. M shell, how many subshells we have means 3s, 3d, 3d, like that. Now from second period you can follow me. What is the statement I was given is absolutely correct. What the statement here I was given? Every period starts with S and ends with P subshell. Except this first period. First period starts with 1s, ends with 1s itself. Second period, so S can have maximum how many electrons? 2 electrons, right? So that I will tell you later. So 2 electrons can fill, so 2 elements can be filled in first period. Why? I told you in previous, S can have maximum 2 electrons, P can have maximum 6 electrons, D can have maximum 10 electrons, F will have 14 electrons like this. Am I given electrons? S have 2 electrons, P have 6, D have 10, F have 14 electrons. So this is very important statement. Every period starts with S and ends with P subshell. So first period starts with 1s, ends with 1s because in the first shell there is no P subshell. So that's why first period ends with S only. But second period starts with S, that is 2s, and ends with 2p. See the energy order I am taking up? Energy increasing after 1s, energy increases to 2s, and 2s to 2p energy increases. Okay, this is 1s only, no need to write, right? 1s after, next we have to fill electrons in 2s. 2s after we have to fill electrons in 2p. Okay, next come to the third period. Okay, so every period starts with S, I told you. So 2p was filled. Now again you will have electron enters into 3s. See, every first period 1, second period 2, third period 3, 3s, fourth period 4s, like that. Getting what I am saying? Fifth period starts with 5s. Very simple now. So first period starts with 1s, ends with 1s. Second period starts with 2s, ends with 2p. Third period starts with 3s, stops with 3p, ends with 3p. Increasing order of energy. 3s after, next we have to fill 3p. Okay, 3p was filled. 3p after, you have 4s. Electron we have to enter in 4s. 4s after, you have 3d. 3d after, you have 4p. See the energy order. 4s after, electron enters into 3D, 3D after 4P. Okay, so this is what period? Fourth period. So you have to observe one thing. What is that? I'll keep one star here. 1s. There is only one exception. First period, sorry. Second and third period has same kind of substance, but only this number is different. Here you have S, here you have P. Here you have S, here you have P. That's it. Means second and third period are same. Right? And fourth period starts with 4S, but 4S after electron enters into 3D. So 3D you have to fill. 3D after you have to fill 4P. Next, fifth period. Now you only tell me, just guess. 4P after what substance is going to fill? 5S. So here 5S. 5S after? 5S after 4D. 4D after 4P you have. Sorry sir, 5P you have here. Next, come to the sixth period. You observe, every period starts with S, ends with P, except this first period. Next, sixth period. So, fifth period ends with 5P. 5P after electron enters into what? 6S. So, 6S. 6S after what subshell must fill? Here you have a problem. Here 3D you have. And here 4D you have. Here you must have 4F. So, this is the way of classification now. Right? So 4F after what is going to fill is 5D. What is going to fill? 5D. Okay, 5D after 6P. So see, 6th period also starts with 6S and ends with this. Get it? See, one more thing. This 4th period and 5th period is similar. Because S, S, D, D, P, P, like this you have. These two are similar again. And 6th period and 7th period will be similar, you can guess. Without looking that you can say. Here what you have? 6s. 7th period, so starts with 7s. It is 4m, here 5s. 5d, 6d. 6p, 7p, like this. That means, here starts with hydrogen. Because hydrogen has 1s. And 1s, 1, increasing order of their energy of substance. And maximum electrons we have to fill. S can have maximum 2 electrons. So here 1s1 and 1s2. That means here hydrogen and here helium. So 2 elements will be present in first period. Because S can have maximum how many electrons? 2 electrons. Got it what I said? S will have maximum 2 electrons. Therefore 2 elements will be present in first period. So elements classification only these. These are not by using these subshells filling. He was classified elements. Understanding? So, 1s will fill in first period. That means, okay, 1s will period for what elements? Okay, 1s will fill for hydrogen and helium. So, 1s 1 will be for hydrogen. So, hydrogen will be in first period. And ends with the S only. But here hydrogen, here helium. Like that. Getting what I'm saying? And second period starts with 2s. That means 2s means what? Lithium. Correct? Because 1s2, 2s1. 2s1 electron enters for which element? Okay, lithium. So second period starting element is lithium. Because lithium configuration is what? Lithium configuration. 1s2, 2s1. So lithium will come as a first element in second period. Ends with P. So P can have maximum what? P6. So ending will be 2P6. 2S2, 2P6. Is neon or not? Okay. Neon is the ending element here. Like that. You have all periods. So, in first period, how many elements you can have? Only 2. And in second and third, same I told you. Here, 2 elements you can fill in first period. And second and third, you can fill 8 elements. So, how you are saying, sir, 8 elements means? S can have maximum how many electrons? 2 electrons. P can have maximum how many electrons? 6. So 2 plus 6, 8. So 8 elements can be filled in each period of second and third. In second period, how many elements will be present? 8 elements will be present. How you are saying? Based on electrons I am saying. Getting what I'm saying? Second period starts with what? 2s1. Ends with what? 2p. Getting what I'm saying? So here third period starts with what? 3s. Ends with what? 3p. So how many elements in each? Second period consists of how many elements? 8 elements. How you are saying? What? 2s have how many electrons? 2 electrons. Whether any s, s have 2 electrons maximum, I told you. So in 2s, 2 electrons. In p, in 2p, 6 electrons. So that means 2 plus 6. 8 electrons you can fill. That means 8 elements you can fill. Similar way, third period can have 8 elements. And fourth period, how many elements can be filled? Fourth period, you tell me. S will have maximum how many electrons? 2. P will have 6. D will have 10. So 2, 10, 6. That means 18 elements can be filled. Getting? In fourth and fifth, both 18 elements you can fill. How I am saying? Based on the number of electrons can be filled maximum. S can have maximum how many electrons? 2. P can have maximum how many electrons? 6. D can have maximum how many electrons? 10. 2 plus 10 plus 6 how much? 18. Getting what I am saying? In that way you can say. Finally, 6 and 7 are same. Here, 32 elements can be placed. Because we are starting with 6s. How many electrons can be filled, those many elements you can classify in a particular period. You can place how many elements, how many electrons can be placed. Those many elements you can place. Okay, I repeat. How many electrons you can place in various subshells, those many elements you can classify. Here 2, F means 14, 2 plus 14. 16, 16 plus 10, 26, 26 plus 6, 32. So 32 elements can be classified in this 6th period. Same way in 7th period. Getting what I am saying? You can check the order once last and final. 1s after 2s, 2s after you are filling 2p, 2p after you are filling 3s, 3s after you are filling 3p, 3p after 4s, 4s after 3d, 3d after 4p are filling, 4p after 5s, 5s after, there you can see, 5s after 4d, 4d after, in this way, 5p, 5p will be end, and again starts with 6s, 6s after filling, you see, 4f, 5d and 6p, in that way, same way, 7s, 5f, 7s or 5f, 6d, 7p. This is the way of filling of electrons in increasing order of their energies. If you know the electrons, how many you are filling, those many elements you can classify and each period. I repeat, in first period, how many subshells can be placed? Only 1s. Second and third period starts with s, ends with p. Second period starts with 2s, ends with 2p. Third period starts with 3s, ends with 3p. Getting what I'm saying? So these all things are very important for us. We must write down all these things, have a screenshot and write down very clearly and post your notes in our WhatsApp group. Thank you.